The goal of the trial is to prove whether this experimental medication improves the response of these tumors to treatment. Oftentimes, tumors that are resistant to prior therapy, prior radiation or prior chemotherapy, they tend to be very difficult to treat and they tend not to respond that well to additional treatments. So what we're trying to do in this clinical trial is to see if this medication proves to stop the tumor growth better than other medications. The reason why we started this trial is because we recognize that these patients with rare CNS tumors very rarely have access to experimental therapies. Most of the times, most of the trials out there are going to be for patients with the most frequent brain tumors, that is usually glioblastomas, and not so much for patients with unusual brain tumor types or spinal tumors. And there's also preclinical data in some of them that suggests that their tumor may potentially respond to this type of trial therapies. So that is the reason why. This trial is designed to treat a number of rare CNS tumors that are part of the NCI Connect program. Actually, these 12 rare tumor types are eligible for one or another trial that is using the same medication. So all of them can participate on a trial that includes this this medication that is trying to work on the immune system to try to make the immune system recognize the tumor. In general, people that are eligible for this trial have one of these rare tumor types and they have a recurrence. That means the tumor was treated with something else earlier on, let's say with surgery, radiation, chemotherapy, and the tumor was able to find its way back. It's recurrent, so that is one of the main criteria. Then there are a few others. Every clinical trial has a set of complex rules built into it. The reason being, we want the patients to be safe. We want to make sure we're not exposing them to risks that are excessive, and we also want to make sure that we are doing good science. So that's why there are these set of rules in there. So these rules are called eligibility criteria, and that is the reason why we need to meet with each patient face to face, and we need to go over a number of tests, including exam in clinic and laboratory results and all of these things, to make sure that they are eligible, that they fulfill all these criteria, so we make sure that it's safe for them and that we are understanding the science and that we are understanding our results. The way this trial medication is given is intravenously. It requires the patients to come here to the treating center, so where they get the medication. The time that patients to stay on the trial is going to depend on their response of the tumor and also on whether or not they are developing side effects that we may or may not be able to manage without stopping the medication. So that is what actually dictates the duration. But provided that the tumor is not growing during treatment and provided they are not having side effects, then the duration can be for up to about a year and a half. It depends again on each case, and we continue to do evaluations of the patient in clinic and imaging studies to make sure that we are going in the right direction, and that is what determines whether someone stays on treatment or not. For a patient to participate in the trial, the very first step is that they come to see us, so we can have that face-to-face conversation and evaluation, and we can decide if actually participating on this trial or any other trial is the best option, or if maybe in their particular situation some other type of treatment, including a standard therapy, is the best way to go.
Learn more at cancer.gov/NCI-connect. Contact us, nciconnect@mil.nih.gov, 240-760-6530.
U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, National Institutes of Health, National Cancer Institute, cancer.gov, 1-800-4-CANCER. Produced April 2020.